The last few years working on rides with Chuck, I've ridden on almost a third of the remaining flying B-17 bombers. One of the most interesting examples that I've come across, though, I can't get a ride on. Hi, you have found Rides with Chuck. In this video, we talk to Mike Kellner. Mike, talk about your project.
Project is saving a B-17e that was built in 1941. And we had found it in a junkyard in Maine and just thought it was an American icon and didn't want to see it destroyed, so we decided we can put it back together.
What did it look like when you got it?
They had actually scrapped the airplane, so they cut the fuselage up into 7 pieces, hacked a lot of stuff up. Their original intent was just to scrap the airplane, and the family that had bought it did a pretty good job of beating it up, and then they grew out of it, I guess, and abandoned it pretty much.
There's a lot of work here.
Yes. Yeah, the airframe was badly damaged, but we've come a long way. And we use exclusively volunteers, and of course we're always looking for parts and funds and grants and anything else that'll help us speed the thing up. But
what is the time frame for completing this?
Well, we have a standing joke around here. We're going to get it done on Thursday, so it'll be some Thursday.
And the other question is, how do you get it out of here?
We'll build all the components here. We won't do the final assembly here because the space isn't big enough. We'll take it to an airport to do the final assembly.
What kind of work, real work, is left on this airplane? What's the next big challenge?
For as far as challenges go, the next biggest one is getting wing spar tube replacement sections made. We're trying to get a tube that nobody can make anymore, I guess. They said they got rid of all that technology to China. It's a drawn tube that tapers on the inside. And that's probably our next biggest hurdle. You know, we've crossed a lot of hurdles.
But is that one soluble? How are you going to solve that problem?
Everything's solvable.
Well, yeah.
You know, if they did it once, you know, somebody will be able to figure out how we can do it again.
Can I ask you really quickly what you're doing?
I'm punching the rivets so that they can drill them out for the drill.
Okay, so you just put a little
dimple in there so they can center the drill to drill the old rivets out, take the sheet metal off.
Good enough. Okay, thank you. You've got a group here today to volunteer.
An EAA Warbird Squadron 4 chapter. They come out once a year and help us.
If somebody else wants to come out and help, well, how do they?
Our normal volunteers come out on Saturday. So we have a normal group of about 8 that comes out on Saturdays. And then during the week, you know, if I'm here, anytime they want to work on it, I try to be here to work on it.
Is there a website or anything that people can go to?
There's aerovintage.com. It's not our site, but they follow us and kind of keep up on it.
Okay. So I can, when I put this together, I can find that and CG it, and people will be able to.
Right.
You are hard to get in contact with.
I prefer phone. I'm dealing with old technology. That new stuff kind of gets.
Have you ever flown a B-17? Are you a pilot?
What is your? I'm a private pilot, and I've gotten some instruction in a B-17. I don't have a sign off or anything yet, but that I can get once we get going.
Okay. What advice do you have for anybody that's trying to restore a Warbird or B-17?
Well, good luck on a B-17. There's just not very many of them around. That's why we started with one this bad off. Takes a lot of work, a lot of hours, a lot of money. Just how important this airplane was to America during World War II. It was pretty much all we had is big bombers at the start of the war. It was the main bomber in Europe throughout the war on the 8th Air Force. Crews loved them. Good, solid, dependable airplane. And we just thought this one needed saving. There's only, 49 left in the world.
How many are actually flying?
About 11 of those. And there's four more being restored to fly. That's not very good out of almost 13,000 of them that were built.
So the other three, you guys must communicate.
Oh, yes.
Pretty regularly.
Yeah, there's actually a group of B-17 owners or operators, and they have a little nondescript co-op that get together to trade stories and parts and things like that.
Well, that's going to be a very unique group.
Yeah, a lot of characters.